The Moon Might Be Milk by Lisa Shulman, illustrated by Will Hillenbrand. The night was almost gone, and a large round moon sank in the sky. Its bright light poured through the window, waking Rosie. "Look at the moon," she said to Cat. "I wonder what it's made of." Cat stretched lazily. "The moon is a saucer of fresh milk," he purred. "It spills from the sky into puddles on the ground." "The moon might be milk," Rosie said, "but it might not."
"Then let's ask Hen," said Cat.
When the sun had risen, Rosie and Cat set off. They walked and they walked until they came to Hen. "Hello, Hen," said Rosie. "Can you tell us what the moon is made of? Cat thinks it's a saucer of milk."
"Milk?" cackled Hen. "Oh, my dear, no. The moon is an egg. Small, shining chicks hatch from it to become the stars."
"The moon might be an egg," Rosie said, "but it might not."
"Then let's ask Butterfly," said Hen.
So Rosie and Cat and Hen went on until they came to Butterfly. "Hello, Butterfly," said Rosie. "Can you tell us what the moon is made of? Cat thinks it's a saucer of milk, and Hen says it's an egg."
"Oh, no," whispered Butterfly. "The moon is made of sugar. It's sticky and sparkling and, oh, so sweet."
"The moon might be sugar," Rosie said, "but it might not."
"Then let's ask Dog," said Butterfly.
So Rosie and Cat and Hen and Butterfly went on until they came to Dog.
"Hello, Dog," said Rosie. "Can you tell us what the moon is made of? Cat thinks it's a saucer of milk, Hen says it's an egg, and Butterfly believes it's made of sugar."
"Well, the moon," said Dog with a wag of his tail, "is a round pat of sweet, creamy butter."
And he licked his lips with his long pink tongue.
"The moon might be butter," Rosie said, "but it might not."
"Then let's ask Mouse," said Dog.
So Rosie and Cat and Hen and Butterfly and Dog went on. Soon they came upon Mouse, scurrying back to her hole.
"Hello, Mouse," said Rosie. "Can you tell us what the moon is made of? Cat thinks it's a saucer of milk, Hen says it's an egg, Butterfly believes it's made of sugar, and Dog tells us it's a pat of butter."
"You're all wrong," grumbled Mouse, anxious to be on her way. "The moon is made of white flour. When the wind blows, it makes great powdery clouds in the sky."
"The moon might be flour," Rosie said, "but it might not."
"Well then, what do you think it is?" asked Mouse impatiently.
Rosie thought for a moment.
"I'm not sure," she said at last, "but maybe Gran will know."
She ran off toward her grandmother's house with Cat and Hen and Butterfly and Dog and even Grumbling Mouse close behind.